Hey, this is Mehdi from Filmcard. If you are interested in using ARRI Alexa cameras, but unfortunately you have not been able to use each of them yet, today I'm gonna show you a way to use a simulated version of them right now. Without wasting time, let's do this. All right, now I'm in ARRI website, as you see with this address, ARRI.com. First, you have to go to this section, Learn and Help, click on it. Now you have to go to camera and workflow and then choose tools and apps. So now you have to go to camera simulators. And finally, as you see, you have some different ARRI products here, such as Alexa Mini LF, Alexa LF, Amira, Alexa Mini, S60W, S60 Plus, and XT Plus, and also Alexa Studio and Alexa Classic. So I'm gonna choose Alexa XT Plus. Let's see how is it. Open in full screen mode. Okay, now we have an Alexa XT Plus. We can use it virtually, as you see. We have some buttons here, such as menu, play, grab, lock, power button, record button, info, TC or timecode, WRS, home button, back button, and this tab that you can rotate it, and these tiny green buttons here. So let's start with FPS. You can choose your frame rates from here, push this button, and after that you see some different frame rates here. You can add custom, you can change the frame rates, you can add your own frame rate, as you see. So after that we have audio setup. Now it's off, it's actually disabled because we need an external mixer that it should be connected with camera. By the way, you can go to option and turn your record on or off. You can also arrange your channels and source channels. After that, we have shutter here. You can go to this section and you see some different shutter angles. You see the frame rates that you have choose, and the exposure time. You can see the shutter speed or exposure times that it sync with each of the shutter angles. You know, if you change your frame rate, your exposure time will be changed. Let me show you. Now in this angle, we have 1.30 per second. But if we change the frame rate to 60 frames per second, now we have 1.60 per second. Okay, so after that we have exposure index. It means sensor sensitivity, that we called it ASA in analog system and ISO in digital system. The minimum and the maximum ASA, as you see, you can choose each of them. So here we have gamma space. You can push the color button. After that, go to gamma and you see the internal. You can change it to Rec 709 or Lock C. You can also change your record out. If you are using external recorder, you can change the color space or gamma space of it. Also, if you are using external monitor, you can change the gamma space of them. Finally, you can change the EVF. EVF means electronic viewfinder. You can choose one of them for your viewfinder. Okay, and finally we have white balance. You see auto white balance, tungsten, fluorescent, daylight, and daylight cool. You can rename them. You also can add Kelvin. You can arrange the temperature. Here you can add green or magenta. You can arrange the hue, push it. If you add it, you are adding green, and if you lose it, you are adding magenta. All right, here you have TC or time code that it's running now. 60 by 9, it's your aspect ratio. ProRes, it's your codec. HD, it's your resolution. Here you have your batteries information, battery 1, battery 2, and their voltage. Reel is the name of your card that you are using. Clip is the name of your file. And duration is the time of your last clip. Now let's go to menu. Here you see recording, internal. So you can change your format, ProRes, DNX, and ARRI RAW. So if you choose ProRes, you can go to settings and follow these codecs. ProRes 422 is a light file. ProRes 422 high quality. It has a high quality, but the file is almost small. After that, we have ProRes 4444. It's a heavy file. And finally, ProRes 444XQ. It's a very, very huge file. By the way, ProRes 422 is 8-bit rate. ProRes 422 also 8-bit rate. And ProRes 444 and ProRes XQ is 10-bit rate. So after that, you can change your resolution, HD 2K or 3.2K. So, but if you use DNX, you have these three codec. This one is 8-bit rate, and this one 10-bit rate, and this one, DNX 444, is 12-bit rate. So, but if you use ARRI RAW format, there is no codec to follow. There is no resolution because you are using all of your gate. I mean, your sensor is on open gate, and you couldn't change the resolution. You couldn't change the format. So let's go to ProRes. From here, you can format the capture drive. You can format the setups. And here, if you are using external recorder, you can arrange the frame rate of your recorder. You can choose this format. Just this, let's go to monitoring. So let's set up the electronic view finder. You can change the brightness, rotate the vision. You can add frame line from here. So if you are also using an external monitor, you can arrange the frame rate. You can use frame lines. If you wanna change your aspect ratio in post-production, you can add some frame lines. It's up to you. Now you see it. Yes, frame line 1, 2. So all the Alexa products have this false color index. It's a list of false color, as you see. So here you have your project setup, sensor mode. You can change your aspect ratio. If you use OpenGate, all your settings, all your setups will be changed to ARRI RAW. Let me show you. Yes, open gate sensor, push both of these buttons in the same time. Okay, let me show you what's happened. Go to recording, internal. Yes, you see the format has been changed to ARRI RAW. Because you are using open gate mode. So let me change it to 60:9. Okay, now you can change your resolution from here. 9280x1080. Okay. So let's check the system. You can set up your SD card. You can change your fan mode. You can arrange your display and arrange your beeper. You can turn it off or turn it on. Okay. Let's go here, push info button. You see some information about your system. System state good. You can go to version, see the information about your camera, media info, the codec, it's a standby. Just this, let's go to TC or timecode. You can set your timecode as you wish. Here, you can change the minutes. Here, you can change the seconds. And here, you can change the frame. Okay. So, let's check the option. From here, from mode, you can put it on Rekron. Now you see it has a stop, and after record, it will running. From WRS, you can arrange the external devices such as radio, such as camera level, lens data, iris, zoom, and focus. You can grab with this button. You can play the files. You can go to clip list, choose your shooting. You can play it or pause it. If you push it in 3 seconds, you can lock the system. Let me show you. Now it's locked, as you see. So you know you can start recording with this button. It's now on standby. If you push it, it's going to record. And the last button, it's power. If you push it in 5 minutes, it's going to be off. Alright, like always, hope you enjoyed our video. If you have any question, do not hesitate to comment them below. I'm gonna answer them as soon as possible. If you enjoyed our video, don't forget to like it. By the way, don't forget to subscribe our channel if you still didn't. Just this. Until next, goodbye and take care.